some of those black jacket rockers on motorbikes are immoderate, to say the least of it. But don't brand them too hastily. This lot, for instance, are members of the famous 59 Club in London's Paddington, where the ton-up parson, Father Shergold, shares the sport they've turned into a social service. The craze for speed and noise is accepted as a teenage mania, an adolescent activity. But some kids get bitten less antisocial than those high-powered motorbikes. What do you make of that lot? Less antisocial than those high-powered motorbikes. What do you make of that lot? But maybe we judge the rip-roaring kids of today too harshly or lump them unfairly together, because look at this map. This is a map of emergencies, of incidents in which quick action is essential. And that's where those rip-roaring kids come into the picture. This is the Volunteer Emergency Service in action. A hospital urgently needs a blood sample for cross-matching after an accident. It's a job for one of the ton-up boys. Tony Roper is just one member of the Voluntary Hospital Messenger Service that is now nationwide. It's a service that started 5 years ago when a postal dispute held up the distribution of smallpox vaccine and a group of young motorcyclists stepped in. Now they carry drugs and documents, medical specimens and what have you, between clinics and hospitals. So those rip-roaring kids, like this one, are doing a job that can often be a matter of life and death. That boy isn't being paid for his services. In fact, he pays for the privilege of being a member of the Volunteer Emergency Service. And he guarantees to keep his motorbike in trim and at the ready for a call that could come at any hour of the night. Sometimes there's a mass call out when, for instance, the police ask for help to search for a missing child. They'll take on any job that is useful to the community that doesn't cut across any commercial or trade union interests. Some of them have roped their parents into the organization, and car owners drive hospital patients and handicapped people on urgent journeys. Some of the members don't own motor vehicles and have joined simply to man the switchboard and work at headquarters. Mission accomplished, and the next job he's called on to do may be less dramatic. A lot of the deliveries they make are routine. But the thing is that members of the Volunteer Emergency Service love driving, and they get more satisfaction out of it when they're driving in a good cause and doing a job for the community. So we've all got to think again about some, at least, of the rip-roaring kids you see revving up their noisy motorbikes. The nurses and doctors have given them a very clean bill of health. Some of those black jacket rockers on motorbikes are immoderate, to say the least of it. But don't brand them too hastily. This lot, for instance, are members of the famous 59 Club in London's Paddington, where the ton-up parson, Father Shergold, shares the sport they've turned into a social service. The craze for speed and noise is accepted as a teenage mania, an adolescent activity. But some kids get bitten by the bug a good deal earlier these days.